Hi, you're with Mike Redding from Google Apps for edu.com. If there was going to be one question that I am most consistently asked when I'm speaking at a staff development day or a conference or with a group of teachers, it would be this. How do I easily send emails to a group of people, whether that be parents or teachers or students? And equally, how do I share a document easily with a group so that I don't have to have a list somewhere and I'm copying, pasting, or typing in email addresses? Well, the answer is there's two ways that you can do this. You could ask your Google Apps administrator to create a Google group and then place those people that you want to share the document with into that group. The other way is that you could just go ahead and create your own contact group just using Gmail to do it. And so I'm going to show you how to create a contact group inside Gmail right now. So here I am in one of my Gmail accounts. And you can see over here on the left-hand side in the top left-hand corner where it says Gmail, there's a little arrow next to it. And if we click on that, we can select our contacts. Now, I have a number of contacts and I'm going to blur these out so you can't see their details. But basically, your contacts can have their email addresses, their names, phone numbers, and so on. And you can also tag your contacts or put them in groups. And one contact can go into multiple groups. So to create a group, on the left-hand side, you'll see that there is a option that says New Group. So I click on the New Group, and I get the option to name the group. So I'm going to call it Demo for this purpose, and click OK. And then your demo group will appear for you under your contacts there. Now, obviously, you don't have anyone in your contact group just yet. So there's a couple of ways that you can go about getting people into your contact groups. If you click on the contact group in the list on the left-hand side, what you can do is just click on the button that has a person and a plus, and it says add to demo, and you can start to type in some names. You can also just copy and paste some email addresses in there, just have them comma separated, and you'll be able to add them by bulk. If you click on the more button, you'll see that there's an opportunity for you to import people from maybe Outlook, or if you've had someone fill out a form and you've collected all their email addresses, you could convert the spreadsheet that goes with that form into a CSV file and you could import it that way as well. Another way that you can do this, if you go to your general contacts, is you could simply just go down and select the contacts that you would like to be added to that group. When you do that, you'll see that there'll be a button with three heads. It looks like a group. If you hover over it, obviously it says group. And you click on it, and then you can select which groups you would like those people to go into. So if we wanted to then share this document with a group, all we simply do is click on the share button. Rather than copying and pasting email addresses in, we simply type the name of the group in there, and then we select it, and you'll see that it drops all their email addresses in here. Now, just be aware that when you send an email to a contact group, Google creates one email per person. Now, the reason you need to just be aware of that is that there are sending limits inside Google. Now, I've pulled up a page here and I'll drop the link into the Google Apps for edu.com blog. So if you go to googleappsforedu.com/creating contact groups in Gmail, you'll be able to see the link to this particular page. But just be aware, if you've got a Google Apps for Education or Business account, you can only send 2,000 emails a day. If you're using an @gmail.com account, that's limited to 500. You can also only send to 2,000 recipients, and only 500 of those are allowed to be external. So just be aware of that. There are some sending limits. Now, if for some reason you need to send more emails than that limit, that's where you need to go back to your Google Apps administrator, ask them to create a Google group. Once they've created that Google group, there's an email associated with it, and Google only treats that group as one email, so you can send it to more users that way. So hopefully that's been helpful to you. If you'd like to leave a comment or you have any questions, then please just leave your comment underneath the video or the audio, wherever you're watching or listening to this, and we can continue the discussion there. If you'd like to receive other Google Apps for Education tips and tricks, I'd love you to head over to the googleappsforedu.com website. There you'll find a whole range of tools and information about how you can better use Google Apps for Education. Thanks for watching.